Vivek Prasanth, thanks for joining me today. And what we want to talk about today is we're at ASCO 2023. We're hearing about some incredible innovations on the therapy side. And more those innovations are dependent on understanding an individual's tumor and the different molecular changes, genetic changes of their tumor. We've come a long way. I've been at a lot of ASCOs over the years, and I think more and more this is part of the discussion. But maybe we start at a high level in each of your roles.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Phil. I think this is one of the best times to be in oncology, drug development. Because think about that. We've come a long, long way, as you said. We have at least 10 to 20 precision oncology drugs being approved. Specifically, diseases like non-small cell lung cancer have become the poster child for precision oncology.
Yeah, couldn't agree more, Phil. I mean, I think the opportunity in front of us is amazing. As Vivek highlighted, for me, it's a very basic question. We're today at a place where we need to answer the first question from a molecular standpoint. What do I have? And everything else stems from that. And once I can characterize the tumor, what's my diagnosis? Then, whether you're in an academic center or in the community setting, that's where we all have to start.
Vivek, you're going to talk about a study looking into that dynamics between small panel testing, single testing, and larger, what we call comprehensive genomic profiling, where you really cover all the potential genes that have variants that could be targeted. And maybe we open up a discussion on that.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you so much. So let's focus on the study being presented at ASCO. Non-small cell lung cancer is now the poster child for precision oncology.
Yeah, for sure.
We have at least 10 different alterations that we have drugs for, and more coming. So a decade ago, we used to do single gene testing for EGFR, ALK, and ROS1. Non-small cell lung cancer, the standard of testing, according to many, many guidelines, should be comprehensive genomic panel. So this study essentially looked into more than 80 community oncology practices on single gene testing and its impact on comprehensive genomic testing. In fact, what this showed was a single gene testing delayed the turnaround time for comprehensive genomic panel, denied the patients access to good quality tissue for them to have a comprehensive genomic panel testing. So again, in 2023, we need to be doing comprehensive genomic panel testing on all patients with lung cancer. Because for lung cancer, we have 10 different therapeutic options. So again, we've come a long way,
yeah. And
I think we need to be offering a comprehensive genomic panel testing on those patients. I think we lose a lot, countless lives may be lost because of single gene tests, because they may not detect alterations.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people can understand the potential. Few people understand when you get down to some of the real pragmatic realities of testing. And LabCorp offers a range of tests. You support the physicians that are ordering those tests. LabCorp also has to face the reality that, you know, if someone had non-small cell lung cancer diagnosed with a bronchial washing or a bronchial biopsy, you're only going to get so much tissue. So maybe you talk a little bit about that, Prasanth, and the realities of how do you, you know, this study suggests you have to be careful with how you sequence testing.
Absolutely, Phil. And I think what you just highlighted there is so important because we have the science, and as both of you have eloquently stated, the science is always evolving, you know, and that's just the nature of science. We learn, we get better. Vivek will again highlight, in his presentation, as to the rates of failure if you do single gene testing up front. It's like twice as high. As opposed to when you do CGP testing up front.
Yeah.
And there's other implications such as turnaround time,
Yeah. Which
is also extended. And that is meaningful days when a patient has a diagnosis, needs to start a therapy, and we're delaying the initiation of therapy because we don't have the right answers.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, it might ages me a little bit, but first time I took the oncology boards, it was about platinum doublets in lung cancer, right? And that's basically what we had. And then maybe Tarsia was starting to be part of the picture. Maybe we could just bring it down to the here and now, Vivek. And as you think about, say you're seeing a woman with, you know, newly diagnosed lung cancer, mm-hmm. walks in to see you as a referral, tissues available. Let's just bring it down to the here and now. Like, what's your process? She's good performance status, wants everything done possible.
Absolutely.
How are you thinking about that now?
So, of course, you know, we need to do the scans, blood work, and all that. And, you know, for a patient who's well, we need to do both tissue-based comprehensive genomic panel. Mm. At the same time, concurrently, we do a liquid biopsy send-out test. Because the liquid biopsy testing usually has a rapid turnaround time.
Yeah.
If I get an ALK fusion in 48 hours, I can start treatment with an effective therapy for a patient.
Yeah, right away.
Sometimes procuring tissue, sending it to the lab, getting it tested, you know, there should be sufficient DNA. That might just take, you know, 7 to 10 days. So we would order concurrent comprehensive genomic panel testing and a liquid biopsy at the same time.
Yeah. All right, well, Vivek, Prasanth, thank you so much. Great discussion, and wish you best, ASCO. Looking forward to seeing you out there, and looking forward to the fabulous presentation.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.